I want to play a game.
How are you? Hopefully healthy and happy always. This time the film recapped wants to tell the plot of the film entitled Jigsaw. At the beginning of the movie we see a policeman chasing a man, named Edgar, in a warehouse. Edgar runs towards the rooftop of the warehouse, where he picks up a remote behind a steel bar. Then, the policemen arrive on the rooftop, and point guns at Edgar. Also, Halloran, a detective, arrives on the rooftop. He orders the policemen to only shoot the remote and not Edgar. Then, Edgar tells them the game is about to start. He proceeds to trigger the remote, which starts a timer in an enclosed room somewhere. In response, the policemen and Halloran shoot the remote. However, someone shoots Edgar in the chest against the order of Halloran. In the end, Edgar is severely wounded, and tells them the game has started. In the next scene, the timer in the enclosed room ends and triggers a buzzer. Then, the buzzer wakes up the five people on chains, with a metal bucket in their heads lined up in the enclosed room. The five people are Ryan, Carly, Anna, Mitch, and an unknown man. On the other side of them, there is a sharp blade attached to the wall. The sharp blades alarm them, and make them shout for help. Then, the Jigsaw announces the rules of the game, that is, the offering of blood will set them free. After that, the chains attached to them, start pulling them towards the blades, which makes them panic. They appear to be clueless on what to do, as they try to pull against the chains. However, the chains continue to pull them. Suddenly, Anna realizes the rules of the game, that is, to offer blood. Then, she proceeds to let her arms be cut by the blades, which immediately frees her. After that, Anna instructs others to let themselves be cut by the blades. Mitch and Ryan follow Anna's instructions right away, which also sets them free. However, Carly does not listen to Anna, and just continues to scream in fear like a child. As a result, Carly's back gets cut by the blade. However, she is able to survive since it immediately frees her. Meanwhile, the unknown man is still unconscious, and realizes too late what is happening. As a result, the chains continue to pull the unknown man towards the blades. He appears to die in the process. In the end, the four of them survive, and the chains bring them towards a barn. Meanwhile, in the hospital, Halloran visits Edgar, who is still unconscious. There, the doctor tells Halloran, it is unsure when Edgar will wake up. In the next scene, a black woman is peacefully running in a park. However, she notices that there is a crowd looking up in front of her. The crowd intrigues her, which makes her look up. As she looks up, there is a dead body with a metal bucket in the head, hanging on the bridge. As a result, she starts to scream in fear. Later in the autopsy room, the forensics, named Logan and Elle, are already conducting an autopsy on the dead body in the bridge. Also, Halloran is there observing the autopsy. After they remove the metal bucket in the dead body's head, it reveals to them the head is cut in half. Then, they notice a jigsaw mark on the neck of the dead body. As they look at the mark, they find a flash drive in the neck of the body. Immediately, they check the files in the flash drive, and they find a voice recording. In the voice recording, the Jigsaw tells them that the game has begun again, and he will take care of the four people left in the game. Back to the barn, the four survivors of the first game are still in chains. Then, a creepy Jigsaw puppet with a bike arrives in the barn. A sign telling them to confess is attached to the Jigsaw puppet. In response, Ryan confidently comments that there is nothing creepy in the Jigsaw puppet. But, when the chains start to pull them again, he starts to tremble in fear. Then, as the chains pull the four of them, Anna instructs them to confess something. In response, Mitch confesses that he sold a bike to a kid, and the kid dies in an accident 10 minutes after. Then, Anna confesses that she lost her baby, and she messes up her marriage. However, the chains continue to pull them. Meanwhile, Mitch notices a voice recorder attached to the Jigsaw puppet. He proceeds to pull it, which makes the chain stop pulling them. Then, three needles fall in front of Ryan, which makes him shake in fear. After that, the voice recorder plays, and tells them that one of them is a thief, who has been injected with poison. Then, it proceeds to tell them what the three needles contain. That is, one with saline solution, one with an antidote, and the other with acid. Additionally, they need to make a choice to inject the needle. Otherwise, the failure to make a choice leads to their death. After that, they figure out that Carly is the thief. In response, Ryan forces Carly to make a choice. Then, Carly sees the number 3.53 written in one of the needles, which is the amount she steals from someone. However, Carly refuses to make a choice. In a few moments, the chains pull them upward, which starts to choke them. This forces Ryan to make a choice and injects the three needles into Carly. As a result, the chains free them. Meanwhile, Carly, who is injected with acid, dies in a painful and bloody death. After that, the three of them use the number in the needles to open the door. The door leads them to another room, with a no exit sign written on the other door. Meanwhile, outside a hospital, Halloran and Logan find a body of a woman with acid burns. Later, in the autopsy room, Logan and Elle, together with Halloran, are having an autopsy of the body, and they find a jigsaw mark on the body's tongue. Later, Halloran goes out of the autopsy room. He proceeds to express his suspicion of Logan to his fellow detective, named Keith. Back to the room, the strings trap Ryan's foot, which makes him unable to move, while Anna and Mitch go inside a small dome inside the room. Inside, they find a remote and get it. As they get the remote, the door of the doom suddenly locks up. Then, they open up the television using the remote, where the footage of Jigsaw plays. The Jigsaw instructs Ryan to free himself from the strings by pulling the lever, or else, Anna and Mitch will be buried alive inside the dome. After that, grains start to fill the dome. At this moment, Ryan needs to make the choice to save them. However, he hesitates to pull the lever, in fear that the strings will cut his foot. In the following moments, sharp things start to fall inside the dome, which makes Anna and Mitch scream for help. This forces Ryan to pull the lever. As a result, the strings cut his foot, which makes him scream in agony. In return, Anna and Mitch are set free from the dome. Meanwhile, Elle brings Logan to her warehouse, which contains torture machines. Elle tells Logan that she is a jigsaw enthusiast, which is why she creates the torture machines. She proceeds to explain to Logan that the design of the torture machine is identical to Jigsaw's design. At the same time, Keith is outside the warehouse, and takes footage of them talking. Later, Ryan, Anna, and Mitch are in a barn room. Mitch sees a voice recorder with his name written on it. Then, he proceeds to get the recorder. As he gets the recorder, a rope pulls him upward towards a blade machine. The voice record tells him that he did not tell the whole story about his sin. Apparently, Mitch sold the bike to a kid, even knowing that the brake is faulty, which leads to the kid's death. As a punishment, he needs to trigger the brake in the handlebar at the end of the blade machine. Then, the blade machine starts spinning, as the rope brings Mitch towards the handlebar. Meanwhile, Anna tries to help by putting metal to stop it. Then, the metal is able to stop the machine, and Mitch feels relief. However, the metal breaks, and the blade machine starts spinning again. As a result, the blade machine grinds the body of Mitch. Meanwhile, in the hospital, Edgar is gone. Halloran angrily reprimands the policeman who guards Edgar at the hospital. Then, Halloran receives a call from Keith, his fellow detective. Keith is in the cemetery, and tells Halloran that they are about to check the body of John Kramer, the original Jigsaw, who is considered to be dead years ago. However, as the casket opens in front of Keith, the body of John Kramer is not there. Instead, they find the dead body of Edgar. Then, Keith tells Halloran the body of John Kramer is not there. Immediately, Halloran tells Keith to get a warrant for Elle. In the next scene, Halloran and Keith raid the warehouse of Elle, containing the torture machines. As they inspect the warehouse, they find a body that appears to be ripped apart by a machine. After that, Keith tells Halloran he will get Logan. Later that day, Keith goes to Logan's house to arrest him. However, Logan convinces Keith that Halloran frames him up. He successfully convinces Keith by telling him that Halloran is the one who shoots Edgar in the chest. This makes Keith redirect his attention towards Halloran as the suspect. After that, Elle meets Logan in his own house. She proceeds to tell Logan that she already knows where the jigsaw game is taking place. She adds that they will go there to save lives. Then, together they drive towards there. Back to the jigsaw game, Ryan and Anna wake up in chains. In front of them, there is John Kramer, who is setting up the game. John Kramer proceeds to tell them their sins, and why they deserve the punishment. Apparently, in the past, Ryan caused his friends to die in an accident due to his reckless behavior. Additionally, he destroys the image of his friend through his police statements of the incident. Meanwhile, in the past, Anna kills her child through suffocation, and blames her husband for the death of their child. After John Kramer narrates their sins, he proceeds to tell them that the only way from now on, is to go backward. Then, he puts a bullet into a shotgun. In the end, John Kramer leaves Ryan and Anna in the room, to let them freely choose, while, Logan and Elle arrive at the barn where the jigsaw game takes place. Together, they explore the barn house. In a few moments, Halloran also arrives inside the barn house, and points a gun at them. Halloran is able to catch both of them off guard. However, they are able to escape and run away from him. Back to the game, Anna feels desperate, and the pressure forces her to make a choice. In her desperation, she picks up the shotgun and tries to shoot Ryan. Then, Ryan remembers the words of John Kramer, which make him think that the shotgun is about to shoot backward. Then, Anna proceeds to shoot the shotgun pointed at Ryan. However, the shotgun shoots backward. As a result, Anna blows her head instead of Ryan. At the same time, Anna destroys the key to their freedom by shooting the gun. Meanwhile, Ryan sees the dismantled key on the floor. This makes him realize that he will die in the chains. At the same time, he realizes that they can be free together if Anna does not choose violence. In the end, this scene shows that John Kramer gives Anna and Ryan a chance for repentance of their sin. However, the selfishness of Anna leads to a foolish choice and ultimately puts her to death. And, she also puts Ryan in demise by choosing violence. Meanwhile, Halloran and Logan are in front of each other inside the barn house. As they wake up, they realize that there is a metal with laser cutters attached to their necks. Additionally, the metals in their neck prevent them from moving. In a few moments, there is a voice that announces that they have already found the game, and they are the last two players. The voice proceeds to provide the instruction to the game. That is, they need to confess their sins, or else the laser will cut their heads. Also, they need to press the button to choose who is the first one to play. After that, Halloran presses Logan's button. As a result, Logan is the first to play the game, and the laser cutter around him activates. In fear of the laser, Logan immediately confesses his sins. Apparently, Logan messes up the X-ray results of John Kramer. This makes John Kramer unable to figure out early that he has cancer. However, after Logan's confession, the laser continues to cut his neck. Then, Logan falls to the ground. After that, it is Halloran's turn to play the game, and the laser around his neck activates. He confesses that he lets murderers and rapists walk away in his work as a detective. However, the laser continues to move. Then, he announces that innocent people died because of him. As a result, the laser stops, and he is able to survive. Suddenly, Logan rises up and removes the metal attached to his neck. Then, Logan reveals to Halloran that he is Jigsaw, and the original Jigsaw game already happened 10 years ago at the exact barn house they are in. After that, he proceeds to show an old corpse of a woman and a man to Halloran. Apparently, Logan is the unknown man in the original game, together with Anna, Carly, Mitch, and Ryan. During that time, John Kramer saves Logan, realizing that he only commits an honest mistake. Then, 10 years after, Logan recreates the original Jigsaw game by using the criminals freed by Halora as the players. However, the difference is Logan only takes 3 players, because the last 2 players are him and Halloran. Then, Logan reveals to Halloran the reason he is among the last players. Apparently, as Logan reveals, Halloran sets free Edgar, who murders his wife. After that, the scene moves towards Logan's narration of his perfect plan, to make it appear that John Kramer is behind the game he created. Then, Logan proceeds to narrate his memories together with John Kramer. In the past, John Kramer told Logan that anger and vengeance could not be the basis of our actions. John Kramer adds that he learns it from Logan. However, Logan tells him that justice would not be possible without anger and vengeance. In response, he tells Logan justice is still possible by speaking for the dead. This scene enlightens us about the idea behind the Jigsaw game, that is, providing justice by speaking for the dead. The Jigsaw speaks for the dead by bringing the people who have committed sins to others to the Jigsaw. Finally, the movie ends in the barn house where Logan announces the sins of Halloran. Meanwhile, Halloran, with the laser around his neck, looks at Logan and seems to be begging. However, Logan continues to trigger the laser and cuts the head of Halloran in pieces. In the end, Logan states that he speaks for the dead, as he exits the barn house in a cool the end. Thank you and subscribe the channel.